First, we have to select a new assembly design. Then unclick the use default templates. Click millimeter newton second assembly design. Then click OK. First, we have to insert the component which we previously created and save. Select a corresponding component. Then click OK. Now we have to apply the constraints for the component. I am going to apply the constraints such as a fixed constraint. Then click OK. Again, we have to insert two more components. Go to the assemble and select assemble. Choose our corresponding component and move it by using a triad and place at the required positions. Cam is a rotating element, so we are going to apply the pin type joint here. So go to the user defined constraint and select a pin type. Then we have to select a corresponding axis of the cam and a shaft. Now the pin joint is applied. After that, we have to create a new constraint in the type of coincident. So select a front faces of cam and a shaft. Now the connection definition is successfully created here. We can rotate the cam in one direction. Just click OK. At last, we have to insert a one component such as a cam follower. Go to the assemble, select assemble, choose our component and open it. By using a triad, we can move the component at the required positions. Here, the follower is create a motion at up and down. So we have to apply the sliding joint. So go to the user defined and select a slider joint. Then select a corresponding center axis of follower and a hole. Now the sliding joints is applied here. Then we have to apply one more constraint, because the follower cannot need to rotate. So we have to arrest the rotating motion of follower. We need to apply the one more constraint. Select a front face of follower and the front face of base element. Now the distance constraint is applied successfully. The connection definition is also created successfully. After that, just click OK. For apply the mechanism, we are going to create a translation movement. So go to the applications and select a mechanism. Inside the mechanism, we have to select a cam mechanisms. Select a cam. In a cam 1, we have to select a reference surfaces. We have to select a outer faces of the cam as a references. So select a corresponding faces for creating a mechanism. After selecting all faces, just click the middle button of mouse. Now the cam faces is successfully selected. Then go to the cam 2. We have to select a follower faces. Then click the middle button of mouse. Just click OK. Then we have to apply the servo motor for creating a rotating motion. Select a center axis of the cam for applying the servo motor, because cam is a rotating element. The servo motor is successfully applied. Main thing is, in a servo motor we have to specify the angular velocity. So just right click on the servo motor symbol and edit the definition and go to the profile details. We have to specify the angular velocity in terms of degrees per second. we have to specify the coefficient, numerical value for the rotation. After specifying the angular velocity, just click OK. After that, we have to go for mechanism analysis for creating a motion or animation. Make sure that your part is assembled correctly, then click the mechanical analysis. Here we have to specify the end time and a frame count based upon your requirement. Just click run for create the motions. Now the mechanism is successfully applied here. The application of CAM is in automobile sectors or engine to open the valves of engine to get the regular updates of my video. Please subscribe in my channel. Don't forget to like and share. Inshallah, we will meet in next video. Thanks for watching.